In the name of Allah, the Most Merciful and Compassionate, by the permission of Chair and all co-chair and participant. My paper title is Simulation of Current State Groundwater Level in Kabul Basin using modified thermodynamics in Kabul, Afghanistan. I am Waliullah Aqili, Water Resource Manager at CRIDA, Capital Region Independent Development Authorities. My presentation contains introduction, method, result, conclusion, and recommendation in the end. Today, all discussion is about the water resources, especially groundwater. In Afghanistan also, we have good surface sources, also groundwater, but lack of economic budget, we don't manage the surface water. The majority consideration is on groundwater, that the government and local people use from groundwater. This is cause that the groundwater level draw down day by day. Also, the municipal water supply system is about 30%, that it is not sufficient for the Kabul resident. In this case, we minus about 70% people using from illegal wells that drills by themselves. In this case, we see every day the groundwater level goes down, and it's a concern for the government and for local people, because when their wells dry and they drill again and deeper. In this case, I modify a time model that to simulate this current groundwater level condition, that why it is draw down, it is caused naturally or artificially. Also, we have another concern besides of the quantity, also quality. Day by day, we lost quantity of groundwater, and beside of that, also quality of groundwater level, groundwater, because we don't have central sewerage system. All the sewerage system diverted to the Kabul River. Kabul River is the only recharged area for the groundwater in the Kabul Basin. As I mentioned, this study is conducted in Kabul Basin, that it is divided in this study to central Kabul sub-basin, upper Kabul Basin, lower sub-basin, and the sub-basin, Shamali sub-basin. I just selected in each sub-basin one or two representative observation wells to see the groundwater situation, groundwater level situation. Yeah, this data is collected from USGS, that they conduct a study in Kabul Basin about 8 or 10 years. Also Afghanistan Geological Survey. And as I mentioned, in every sub-basin, I selected one or two observation well to check the condition. This is a modified thing model that, as we see, this thing is the original thing model, but this is modified by me, that I consider here a snow tank and combined thing, because in Afghanistan, especially in Kabul, in the winter we have a snow. There is no rainfall and also no surface water to infiltrate to the groundwater. Also, during the spring season, there is a snow melting and surface flow or rainfall time, we have huge of water in the Kabul River. In this case, this caused suddenly the groundwater level increase, and because the Kabul River infiltrate groundwater suddenly. As we see here, that when precipitation comes and majority of people water is run off, and some of them is infiltrated to the second tank. Also, in this combined thing with it from second tank, also recharge observation well. Oops, sorry. And from second tank, third tank shows the groundwater level. Also from groundwater level, recharge the observation well. This is observation well that shows why suddenly groundwater level increased in this season. This is the formula that we use in this model, that DH1 to DH3 shows the storage of each tank, and Q11, Q21, or Q31 is the runoff rate. Also, Q1 and Q2 is the infiltration rate from tank from first tank to second and second to third tank. This is the snow tank that when there is temperature is equal or less than zero, there is a snow, no runoff. When the temperature is over the zero, there is rain also. We consider the snow tank storage also snow runoff. This formula is the combine of second and third tank that shows the second and third tank groundwater level. We consider it for groundwater level in the observation wells. In this study, for the finding of coefficient of each parameter, the CEO is used to find the coefficient. But for the accuracy of this model is used RMSE and NSE. This model is applied in this well that we consider the temperature, evaporation, and precipitation. And this is mesh. Because we consider this model just for natural factors, why this groundwater goes down. Then this is in this well, it's work that this well drawdown is just natural factor affecting. But in the other wells, I use this model that also it is work or not. But I find there is a gaps between the observation data and simulation data. Because here is over pumping, because it is the residential area, there is illegal wells. But I couldn't find the pumping rate to calculate in this model. But just I understood that there is gap as the lack of pumping data. And here is over pumping. It's not initial affecting to draw down the groundwater. Also, in this well, the same. We see here that if there be no over pumping, the groundwater level should be here. But now it is here. This gap is shows that there is over pumping because day by day the groundwater level goes down. Also, the other in each sub basin I apply it, and we see the result. Yeah, this is a little affected by over pumping, and others initially. This is initially affected, and this one it is opposite of the mentioned wells that. We see here that the groundwater level is increased because also in this paper, I don't consider without precipitation no any other data like irrigation canal or springs because there is any extra recharging sources. In this case, the groundwater increase. Based on the natural factor that it is precipitation or evaporation or the groundwater level should be here, but this is increased. Also, the second one is also the same. We see the groundwater level is here because of some extra recharging. As a conclusion, we found in this study that in the Southern Kabul sub-basin, groundwater level is caused natural factor, but in the second well is the cause is natural factor in over pumping. Also, in upper Kabul sub-basin is the first well and second well is natural and over pumping causing. But in lower sub-basin and this sub-basin, there is some seasonal fluctuation. But in the duration of the study, in long term, the groundwater is stable. In Shamali sub-basin, as I mentioned in the previous slide, that in the first well and the second well, the groundwater levels increased because of some extra recharging. Also, I have some recommendation here to our authorities that in this study, the observation well data is not so exact. As I mentioned, there is needed enough data to consider. Also, the pumping data, we should find the pumping data maybe by social survey, or we consider or assume some assuming data. Also, establishing of central databases recommended because of their every organization conducted some study, but until now there is not collected or unit by in one database. In the central Kabul sub-basin, there is over-pumping or upper Kabul sub-basin. In this case, it is proposed to control because of inside of this groundwater, we should use from surface water to protect from air subsidence. We wonder if we extract more groundwater, maybe subsidence occurred. Okay, thanks for your kind attention.